So you might own the iPad Pro and use it mostly for productivity and getting things done. But a lot of people, including myself as of recently, use the iPad Pro for gaming. I thought I'd make a list of 5 of my favorite games for the iPad Pro. Of course, they're not all free. Some of them you need an Apple Arcade membership to play, but it might be worth it because these games are really good. Before I get into the list, I'm going to kindly ask you guys to subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already, and I do giveaways monthly. In fact, I'm doing a giveaway right now. So in about 2 weeks, I'm going to announce a winner for a $25 Amazon or Apple gift card. All you got to do is be a subscriber and comment down below your thoughts on the video, and I'm going to announce the winner in 2 weeks. Let's get into it. Sayonara Wild Hearts. Sayonara is an arcade game that involves riding motorcycles, dancing, skateboarding, and more. It features a cool character that is visited in her sleep by a butterfly that transports her through a highway in the sky. The game looks so visually appealing. I play it just for the graphics and color schemes. The levels are pretty well thought out, and it features a lot of levels that are also action-packed. Once you get the hang of it, you should be flying by the levels, but if you don't get the hang of it like I did, that's okay. The game allows you to reset or skip a level if you continue to make mistakes. This game is loads of fun to play and brings you back to the times of arcade gaming that has, of course, been displaced by full console style gaming. If you're in the market for a new iPad game, I'd recommend Sayonara Wild Hearts. Next up is Tom's Gold Run. For those trying to relax and pass some time while working from home, we've all done this, there's Tom's Gold Run. Talking Tom has been on iOS devices for as long as I can remember, and in this game, really similar to Subway Surfers, you are Tom, or you can be other characters in Tom's universe. And you're trying to get as many gold coins and objects as possible. It's an endless runner, and you can upgrade your home and get more perks. The longer you play, the harder the game gets, and it's honestly quite addictive. My 2-year-old niece showed me this game, and it's got my whole family addicted. It's seriously good and worth it. The one downside is there are a lot of ads, but other than that, it's a free game to play, and I'd recommend it. Next up is Unpossible. I've been playing Unpossible for years. Thank God I walked into Starbucks that fateful day and picked up their free app. Do you guys remember those days when the Starbucks still do that? The game is an endless obstacle course game where basically you have to avoid all obstacles. Like Sayonara, it's very retro and gives me a Tron arcade vibe with its blue color scheme. The game sounds easy by its description, but it becomes harder and harder the longer you play. It features different modes that are unlockable, and it uses the orientation of the iPad to move you through the game, and you kind of get that feel of driving a race car. If you like games that can be quite difficult, Unpossible is for you. I mean, it's in the name. Samurai Jack. This game is a recall to my early years of watching TV and playing Samurai Jack on the computer with my classmates because it used to be my daily routine. So of course I'd include the upgraded iPad version of Samurai Jack Battle Through Time in this top 5 list. It's such a great game. The graphics, boss scenes, battles, weapons upgrades, and overall fun easily puts this in my top 5 games. You are essentially a samurai that teams up with his old allies from the TV show and the classic games to defeat all types of enemies. The more you play, the more upgrades you can apply to make yourself the ultimate warrior. As mentioned, the graphics are really something here. The characters look flawless, and the world you're playing in is truly immersive. It feels and looks better than some games on my Nintendo Switch. Samurai Jack is a great title on the iPad Pro, and I'd recommend it if you're looking for a new game to play. Last but not least is The Pathless. I downloaded this game pretty randomly, and I never played it for a few months before finally giving it a try, and I was blown away by how fun this game is. The Pathless puts you into the shoes of the hunter, a master of archery who travels to an island to get rid of a curse gripping the world. You have an eagle companion and can do some cool acrobatics and trick shots with your bow and other weapons. You can sprint across long distances, which really comes helpful in this open world. There are lots of secrets, forests, and random climates that make this game fun to play. Again, the graphics here look stellar and it's truly immersive. I was really impressed by how well this game looks. This game is a game that I'd say feels close to a console style game with how open and vast this world is. It's seriously addictive and I definitely recommend it if you're looking for a new game to play as well. So what did you think about the games on the list? Are these some of the games that you know already, or do you have any better suggestions for me? I think I'm going to be doing this, you know, a couple times a year as I review and play more games. And of course, I'm not saying that these are the best games in the world, but these are just my favorite games that I've played so far. So if you got any other suggestions for games, please drop them in the comments below. Give this video a like if you found it helpful, and just make sure to subscribe. Of course, if you want to win the $25 gift card, all you gotta do is be a subscriber and comment down below. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.